The quest to know more about the origin of life and the universe is intriguing and spurs many innovations. One of such innovations is the development of the telescope, which would be used for studies and research about space and origin of life. The James Webb, which is set to revolutionize space. And so, what do we know about the James Webb Telescope? And how powerful is the newly deployed James Webb Telescope? Find out more in this video. Stay tuned. The JWST is easily the most advanced telescope ever built by NASA since the organization began to produce telescopes. The telescope was recently launched to replace the previous telescope, which was rendered obsolete. Since it was launched, we are beginning to see what stuff this telescope is made of. For starters, the James Webb Space Telescope is the newly built space telescope, as earlier mentioned, and it would be used primarily for research about infrared astronomy. The U.S. National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA, led the development of the telescope in collaboration with the European Space Agency and the Canadian Space Agency. The JWST was launched on December 25, 2021, on an ESA Ariane 5 rocket from Kourou, French Guiana. The JWST is poised to replace the Hubble Space Telescope as NASA's flagship mission in astrophysics. Interestingly, you should ask why the telescope was named James E. Webb. The telescope was named after James Webb, who was the administrator of NASA from 1961 to 1968 during the Mercury, Gemini, and much of the Apollo programs. What makes the telescope special? The JWST has a greatly improved infrared resolution and sensitivity, and it's so powerful it could view objects in space that are too old and distant for Hubble. It was touted that it could view some objects up to 100 times fainter. These specifications imply that the telescope would be capable of carrying out several investigations across many fields, including astronomy and cosmology, such as observations of first stars and the formation of the first galaxies, as well as detailed atmospheric characterization of potentially habitable exoplanets. Interestingly, the JWST has a primary mirror, which is referred to as optical telescope element, consisting of 18 hexagonal mirror segments made of gold-plated beryllium, which combined to create a 6.5-meter or 21-foot diameter mirror, compared to Hubble's 2.4-meter or 7.9 feet. This gives the Webb telescope a light collecting area about 6.25 times as large as Hubble's. Webb's collecting area is 25.37 square meters compared to Hubble's 4.0. Unlike Hubble, which observes in the near ultraviolet, visible, and near infrared spectra, JWST will observe in a lower frequency range from long wavelength visible light red through mid infrared. The telescope must be kept extremely cold, below 50K, which would be minus 223 degrees Celsius or minus 370 degrees Fahrenheit. This is to observe faint signals in the infrared without interference from any other sources of warmth. It is deployed in a solar orbit near the Sun Earth L2 Lagrange point, about 1.5 million kilometers from Earth, where its five-layer kite-shaped sun shield protects it from warming by the Sun, Earth, and Moon. But how does this telescope view the planet Proxima B? The planet Proxima B is part of the group of planets referred to as the exoplanets. Within the universe, there is a group of planets referred to as exoplanets, and they are a group of planets that are located outside the solar system. The universe is one big, mighty space that is so wide, inside the universe are groups of solar systems consisting of giant stars with planets revolving around them. For example, our solar system consists of the Sun, which is the giant star with the planets, including Earth, revolving around it. These planets also revolve around their giant stars. The first exoplanet was detected in 1992, and more have since been detected. As of today, 4,906 exoplanets have been detected, with more still being detected. But how are these planets discovered? Well, there are many methods of detecting exoplanets, but transit photometry and Doppler spectroscopy are the most effective, and these methods suffer from a clear observational bias favoring the detection of planets near the star. Thus, 85% of the exoplanets detected are inside the tidal locking zone. Of all the 4,000-plus exoplanets, the only exoplanets that have intrigued scientists so far have been the Proxima B exoplanets. The planet has a recent discovery, which was discovered in 2016, located about 4 light-years away from the Earth. It is regarded as the closest exoplanet to Earth. Proxima b is a super-Earth exoplanet that orbits an M-type star. Its mass is 1.27 Earths. It takes 11.2 days to complete one orbit of its star, and it is about 0.0485 astronomical units from its star. The planet has intrigued scientists because of its features. Many scientists within the NASA community strongly believe that the planet has a high tendency for hosting extraterrestrial life due to its position in the star's habitable zone. Whether it is habitable is a complex function of several unknown properties, such as whether it has an atmosphere. Proxima Centauri is a flare with intense emission of electromagnetic radiation that could rip an atmosphere off the planet. The planet's proximity to Earth offers an opportunity for robotic space exploration, for example, with the Breakthrough Starshot project. But because of how far the planet is from us, there is no way we can tell if this planet could support life, and this is where the James Webb Telescope would come into play. The 21-foot foldable telescope is humanity's latest eye in space. All right, I know you have enjoyed this video till now. Be sure to subscribe to this channel and turn on your notification to get more updates from Glancy Tech. In the case of JWST, the vibrant newly built telescope would help scientists understand the puzzling questions of how we got here and if there are alien lives out there. It would examine our universe from the angle of molecules, stars, galaxies, black holes, and planets that populate the universe. From these studies, ingredients necessary for life could easily be established. The results would help us determine the feasibility of life outside of space. To search for answers, JWST will observe hundreds, maybe thousands of exoplanets before its mission is done. It will stare at hellish lava worlds with molten surfaces that whip around their stars in mere hours. It will study worlds that somehow survived the violent deaths of their stars and now orbit their leftover stellar corpses. It will gaze through the atmosphere of gas giant planets, search for newborn worlds among the dusty disks that cling to infant stars, and squint at a handful of small rocky worlds that just might be similar to Earth. One of the features that scientists hope to harness is the remarkable power of the James Webb Telescope to detect artificial light. LED lights may be detectable from Earth with a powerful James Webb Telescope. The James Webb Space Telescope will have a wider spectrum view than its predecessor Hubble and operate further out from the Earth. At a solar orbit 930,000 miles from the Earth, it would be able to see deep into the universe. James Webb would be able to detect the narrowband light that is reminiscent of LED bulbs, which in turn would be able to characterize the atmosphere of the planet. Doing so will allow researchers to use instruments on the observatory to detect how much energy transport occurs on the planet and then perform calculations of light curves to determine whether they match those of an LED light source. Researchers believe if we are going to finally crack the puzzle of life in space, the detection of artificial light, especially in Proxima b, could be pivotal. Already, scientists have reasons to believe life could exist there, as the planet has the following characteristics. Composition: it is rocky and a similar size to Earth. Temperature: it lies in the habitable zone of its star, which means there could be liquid water on its surface, a key ingredient for alien life. The temperature on the surface of the planet could be between minus 90 degrees and 30 degrees Celsius, or between minus 130 and 86 degrees Fahrenheit. Atmosphere: if Proxima b has an atmosphere, the simple ingredients, water, carbon dioxide, and rock that are needed for the formation of biochemical cycles that we call life, could all be present and interacting on the planet's surface. But the problem is, Proxima b is tidally locked, and it has a permanent day and night side. If there were to be any civilization over there, they may have to illuminate the night side using mirrors launched into orbit or placed at strategic points. In that case, the light shining onto the permanent night side should be extremely powerful, and thus more likely to be detected with the JWST. But what do you think about this planet? Do you believe the James Webb Telescope would capture the much-anticipated artificial light? Be sure to check out our next video.